Yeah. Put that gun away, Shady.
Oh.
Yeah. Oh, major look. Just a page in my rap book. All right, check it out, man. We got Big Mac in the building. Hey, we're briefly out there talking about it. Your management now. You got a new manager.
Yeah, I got a new manager, Ruhel, name brand media, branded management. My new team that manages me, and I was saying, it's just he's on the day to day. He's always on me, call me up, like, what you doing? Are you working on something? Listen, tomorrow we're gonna do this. And just constantly on me, and letting me know that, to push forward, bro.
Like, what? You're just on the couch watching TV. He's like, shows up, right, pulls in front of the crib. Fuck that, huh? We got work to do, man.
Yeah, sometimes, but, I want to say about 85, 90% of the time, he rolls up, I'm working.
Yeah.
I'm always on the grind,
I mean, I already know you're a worker anyway, dog. You keep in the studio. And you got the studio at your crib, too, right?
Yeah, I do. I got the studio at my house, so I walk in there whenever I want, work whenever I want. It's a great feeling, man, because back in the days, I didn't have that, man. I came from the era where I went to go record in a big studio, and it was like the engineer was like, yo, you got a couple of takes. You better get it right, because that's all the tape you get. Because if you didn't get it right, there was no such things as punches. And if they were punching it, it had to be like some clever type of way how they did it, because it was on reel to reels.
On that one take shit.
But nowadays, kids got computers and it started with Cubase or Fruity Loop and all that stuff. And then advanced Pro Tools now what it is, and it's a blessing, man. I look at it like a blessing because I can work whenever I want. I don't have to hire and go to a big studio and record a demo, because if you look at it back then, it was like, man, if you got that, that's like, man, that was precious. You got to go to the studio and you drop 3 songs. But when you got your own studio, you can work at any time and drop 100 songs.
It's a lot cheaper, too.
Oh, a lot cheaper, bro, because you had to pay the engineer, the guy that's running the board. You had to pay the studio time. You had to pay the producer to run all the instruments and every single instrument through the
Well, I think, and it directly affects, like, the creative process. Like, now you're able to have that creative process in your own studio and not worry about that time. Because, when you're paying by the hour, it's like you got to be creative somewhere else. And then when you get in that studio and pay those hours, you got to be ready to drop.
Yeah,
you know what I mean?
And sometimes, I don't know, I'm the type of guy that likes to work on the music right then and there. I hate re-recording stuff because it's, for me, I can never do it the same because I rap by heart and by my soul and my passion. So whatever I'm feeling at the moment, that's what it is. I have a hard time of dropping something and then going back and trying to re-record it. I can never get it the way I dropped it.
And then like you said, and that organic feeling when you're in there vibing out, and someone puts on that new banger, it's like, man, you gotta go with what you feel right there, man.
Yes, sir.
Hey, I wanted to ask you, how's Spirit doing, man? Shouts out to Spirit, by the way. He used to do a lot of music with him, yeah.
Yes, sir. We did a lot of music together. He's still out there. He's grinding. He got some song with Clyde Carson called Swang. It's getting good on the radio, and he's still pushing, and he's still out there grinding, doing his thing.
That's what's up, man. What up, Spirit?
Shout out to David Leon on this last video on COD. He shot that video. David Leon also shoots stuff for Boxers and War Tape. And my nephew's a boxer. Shout out to Hugo Centeno. 21-0, 11 knockouts. Working with Golden Boy, so all around family grinding.
I want to talk about that too, because you're heavy into it now, training cats too, right? Some of the youngsters and shit.
I train kids. I'm starting from the bottom, learning everything. I've been around boxing all my life, but ever since I was 16 years old is when I picked up the sport. And I picked it up because I was good friends with Fernando Vargas. I don't know if you guys are familiar with him, with Ferros.
Yeah.
He was actually my manager, and the reason why my name is Tank, he gave me my name. So me and him were close friends. I would go to the Colonia Boxing Gym and go with him, and I learned a lot of stuff back then. And so it was always like my second love. I love music, and I also love boxing, So now to be able to train the kids, for me it's a blessing, because not only am I training them in boxing, but I'm also training them in life, because some of these kids, they're really going through some hard struggles.
And
man,
they don't have sometimes them strong role models.
Yeah,
too,
and to be there, I know I'm that role model, so it's kind of different because of my music. I take a different perspective. I think about what I'm going to talk about now, but I still let out the realness in the way that I know how,
That's dope, man, because that's important what you said. Sometimes, you know, these kids don't have that guidance or direction, and you could provide that. But you're someone that they could also relate to, too. It's not like, you know what I mean? Like,
yeah, it's not like I'm a square. I've been there, done that, you know? I've been around the block a couple of times, and you know, I wasn't the smartest kid growing up. I always learned the hard way, you know? So to see these kids, I'm like, yo, man, don't be like me. Don't try and learn the hard way. There ain't nothing cool about that. Trust me. Yeah, I've been there. I've done that. And at the end of the day, I regret it all.
That's right, man. Keeping it real, man. And that's a good role model for these kids to have, man. And when is your primo, right, Hugo?
Oh, no, my nephew, actually.
Nephew, my bad. What's his next fight?
He just fought, like, 3 weeks ago, so... He has a month off. They give him a month off, and then after that, usually month or 2 months, we let him cool down, and then we figure out his next opponent, because now he's getting to the level where he's about to have those big fights and
got
those
a lot of opportunities. Got a lot of knockouts, yeah. Too, under his belt, right?
11 knockouts right now. 11 knockouts.
Nice. Yeah. Nice. And now he's at a point where you got to really study your opponent. It's just not like, you know?
Yeah, well, actually, As an amateur, even in the amateurs, there's amateurs that study other amateurs that know them. At any time in the sport, you gotta always study your opponent, because you never know. You gotta know what you're getting in there with, you know what I mean? So you gotta know certain things your opponent does so you can counter, and just all kinds of different things in boxing. But he definitely has to study them much more than before, because the caliber of fighters are going to be a lot more serious, and it's going to be a lot harder as he goes, but he's ready for it. He's been doing it all his life, and he's ready to get that belt around his waist and, you know, represent Oxnard the right way, like a true gentleman.
That's right, man. And that's dope to see that, though. And then Tank has his hands in a lot of different mixes, including boxing, and music real heavy. So make sure you guys stay tuned for what he's doing. I'm working to get at you and all that stuff, man, and check your music out.
Yo, check me out on Instagram, Big Tank Boss. On Twitter, Big Tank Boss. On Facebook, Big Tank Music. Follow me on YouTube, Big Tank Boss. Google me. Check me out. Follow everything I'm doing. You see I mess with kids. You see I do my music. I got my mixtapes going. I do shows. You know, all last year I was across the world. I was in Japan. Shout out to all my Japan fans, all my Japan people. Went to Mexico. Did a show with Sekan in Mexico. Man, and all across the United States with Frost and Down. And man, it's been a blessing so far, man. And I'm not done. I'm ready to keep going.
Out there grinding, man. And we talked about it off air, but Japan was a trip, right? The way they embrace our culture, man.
Yeah, man. You know, I went out there with Kid Frost, and I was opening up for him. And when they picked us up from the airport, they picked us up in lowriders, bro. We're rolling in lowriders, bro. I was like, what? We're in Japan in lowriders, riding around, and we were deep. Well, I'm not talking one lowrider. I'm talking about six lowriders and like four Harleys, and then plus the homies in the Suburban, and they were deep. And they really embrace our culture, man. I mean, there's all kinds of different styles. There's the new homie style, and you got the OG homie with the Cortez and the long dickies and the socks all the way up to his knees with the Lokes and the long white tee. They were all there, bro.
That is dope, man. I got to get down there one of these days, man. I got to travel somewhere.
And then on one of the shows, man, this girl came out wearing a mariachi outfit. She was straight Japanese, but she was in a mariachi outfit. Another homie came out wearing a Mexican luchador mask that was a Mexico color, green, white, and red.
That's what's up, man.
And it was a trip, bro. I met these other two girls that had Echo and... I forgot wherever they're from, but they said it had the Mexican eagle, and it was the whole symbol, and they had it tattooed on their forearm, and it said where they were from. But it said Echo and...
From what part of Japan they were from?
From what part of Japan they were from. Yeah. I was like, wow.
Yeah, with the face tats and everything, man. I got to meet a couple of those homies when they come down this way,
and
man.
And they
it's
were all
trip.
Respectful and cool, man. I mean, they embraced us. They showed us so much love. I mean, when we rocked the show, man, it was like... Hands were up in the air, and they were like, whatever we said to do, they were on it, and they were showing so much love. They love the music. They follow me on Instagram, and they're always supporting.
what I always trip out on is how, like, in other countries or whatever, when an American or show or whatever, when they're rocking, how they sing along with it. Because I always trip out because I'm thinking, I don't think I'd be able to sing along in their language, dog. Like, it seems hard to me, but they sing along songs like it ain't nothing in English, dog. You know what I mean?
No, and they know it word for word. And they don't skip a beat on it, you know, and they're on it. I mean, they don't hold back nothing, you know. Sometimes, not to knock anything, but sometimes out here in Cali, you know, when you do shows, you got
the guy's holding up the wall.
There's not one guy in there like that. Now, not one person in there like that. Everybody is just for the love of music. When they hear that sound, they hear that beat drop, they're just into it, bro.
That's how it should be, man. That's hip-hop shit right there. Thank you for coming through, Tank, man. I really appreciate it, man. Yeah. Hey, shout-outs, man. You got any shout-outs?
Yo, shout-outs to MBM, Brandon Management, Icon Music, all the 805, the B-Side Show, Wacko Rabbit, DJ Shady, you know what I mean? Everybody here in the building, thank you guys for having me.
That's what's up, man. Big Tank, man. Follow his music, follow his movement, man, all that stuff. We'll be right back. We got what video are we going to play, man? You go ahead and lead into this video.
Oh, let's go into this video with Sekan that I did. Flew all the way to Guadalajara. I did half of the video here in LA and half of the video and most of the video in Guadalajara. And here it is, man. Concrete, R2S Films, Master Tracks, Icon Music, MBM, Sekan, all the homies, El Perro de la C, ya saben. Big Tank Boss.
Yeah. Check it out.